Hey guys, Chris and Jeremy here from Harmony Turbines. We're sitting in front of our wind tunnel in the process of disassembling it a little bit so that we can swap parts out for better parts. Not really better, but just more suited to our needs. So we have a mounting box in there now that was originally holding the motor long ago. We have, through an evolution of trial and error, come up with some much better ways to do our data gathering. And now we need a shorter mounting box because our new motor that we're putting on here is a little bit substantial compared to what we had on it. This little toy that we had before, we don't even have it anymore. But it was, oh, there it is.
There's a version of it.
Yeah, and that might've been it. So that was what we had on here before. It was not substantial enough. Now we're putting a larger motor on, so we need a little bit of room underneath this guy. So the old motor actually was inside of the box, so the box was a little larger. Now we're actually mounting underneath it, so we need a little bit shorter box. Anyway, we wanted to talk about this process because, Jeremy, you've been doing a little bit of testing here with our new system. What are you seeing as far as our results go?
We felt like our motor was a little undersized, like we could overdrive it with the model size that we had for our turbine. So we felt it would really be pertinent to go with a larger design, a larger motor, which meant we had to redesign our bearing block that we're going to mount the motor on because we were just limited on space. So it's pretty simple. It's nothing earth shattering.
Yeah, the benefits of this, I mean, these are just RC motors that we're getting, but using it as a generator, we're able to put more load on our turbine. So instead of overdriving it, the little one, the little motor that we were using before, everything was just kind of a function of RPM. So now, you know, we're trying to load it down more and get a little bit more accurate data.
So we get like, yeah, real world scenarios.
Exactly.
Type of testing.
Yep.
I was just going to say, this is just our little video of us changing out the bearing block. So
yeah,
hopefully it'll go well.
And it's back here. We've done a little bit of rework. We've started numbering things. We're going to retest all of the turbines that we got through before, because as we started looking at and examining the data, it really was kind of showing a skew toward a function of RPMs, a function of the diameter being the major contributor to the RPMs, which were giving us false readings. And in a turbine scenario that's out in the real world, it's torque times your RPMs that matter. So that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to get to a point where we're actually loading down the turbine correctly and able to get that data accurately. So I think we have finally come up with a system that's working for us. The new data that you've only done, four or five turbines so far, but it really seems like we're properly loading it down and showing correct data in opposition to the wind, you know, because that's what it's all about. You have to oppose that wind. You can't just free spin. The turbine on the roof isn't free spinning. It's being opposed by the generator. If we're not doing that in the wind tunnel, then we're not doing a good job at reflecting correctly what
real world situations.
Yeah, you have to mimic what the real world is doing with your turbine for it to be accurate. So we joked saying that all these other studies and everything out there, I don't know if they really accounted for that. Some of the studies, when you really dig into them and start getting into the data, appear to be a function of nothing more than the RPMs or the diameter of the turbine they were testing that was giving them their amazing results. And that's not real world scenario. So we're hoping to be better with our data capturing. I'm hoping that this gives us a proper representation of that. It's exciting to see that we can improve something so simplistic to where it might actually have huge ramifications for our full-size models.
Yeah, and the benefit of the wind tunnel testing is in an hour and a half, we can 3D print a whole pallet. I think three different sizes we can get on at one time at our current model scale, where it would take us weeks to build a real-life one-to-one replica.
Right. And then just one unit.
Yeah,
just here we can test three of them.
Yeah, we can test all types of
even if it
parameters.
Took us 2 or 3 hours to get those three in and tested, that's
absolutely
like exponentially faster than
absolutely
doing
so this
full
is all
size.
About optimization and just making sure we deliver the best product that we can.
Yeah, 3D printer technology is great to leverage towards quickly and rapidly prototyping and testing things, so long as you have real world
conditions
accuracy.
Yeah.
You know, 1-to-1.
Yeah.
You have to have an analog of what you're doing outside in the real wind. Otherwise, your data is just bunk. Okay. We're going to get to it, guys. Just wanted to give you this little intro of what we're doing over here. We'll do some other sessions where we're maybe showing the data. I don't know. You know, we'll have to see if that's if that's secret sauce that we, you know, if we finally figured out how to do the wind tunnel testing correctly. I'm not sure I want to show that to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
So, all right, guys. Thank you. Chris and Jeremy from Harmony Turbines signing off. Happy chilly. What is it today?
It's like 12 degrees outside.
Yeah, my God. Yeah,
-6 wind chill.
It's like really
ouch.
Chilly. And by the way, we're going to show, Cheryl's going to actually put on her coat and go out and show some footage. We'll go over and show it on the database, but we were recording in the midst of our really, really heavy snow that we were getting, not compared to Alaska and stuff, but Lebanon County heavy snow. We were spinning right through that storm. So we'll show you the database. We'll show a little blurb of that in this footage. But we were spinning through it, and even this morning when we got in, the turbine's continuing to spin freely. So we'll show that.
Hmm? It'll be next episode.
Oh, not this episode. All right, so did I screw that up? Okay, well, it'll be in the next episode. You can put that in. It's fine. All right, take care, guys.
Bye.
Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.